A lot of times, it's not just BOD and TSS that we're trying to remove. So when you're looking at fast systems, you also want to be able to treat total nitrogen. And we have two products that we would typically follow a fast system with, whether it's a microfast or a high-strength fast. That is taking care of the BOD and the TSS and maybe some of the total nitrogen initially. But when you really need to target a low total nitrogen number, the two products, which some of you are familiar with, NatureWorks has done several installations that use both of these products. We will follow a microfast or a high-strength fast with the NitroFast system. This is going through the additional nitrification process, or rather the conversion of more of the organic nitrogen and ammonia to an oxidized form of nitrogen of nitrate. And you can talk to any of our process engineers about that process later on if you have, you know, kind of questions about that. Just know that nitrogen has a part one and a part two removal process. NitroFast is doing part one to completion, and then the ABCN does the part two. So the part two being what's called denitrification, that's what actually takes nitrogen out of the water, and it does it by biologically converting that nitrogen to a gas, and then that gas just leaves through the vents. So the model sizes for NitroFast and ABCN match up with the model sizes for MicroFast and for high-strength fast on the larger sizes. So roughly speaking, they're rated for the same gallons per day. However, we size each one of these based on a number of factors, and that's why we want to work with you to select these in any case if we, you know, if you feel they're needed and we determine they're needed. We'll want to know the climate, you know, try to estimate wastewater temperature, what the influent and effluent estimates for nitrogen will be, so that we can properly select the combination of these systems. So a brief example here for kind of comparing two treatment schemes. So the top flow chart showing a, maybe this is a commercial facility where we have wastewater from the facility. We have usually a settling and screening tank, which is taking care of bulk solids ahead of the advanced treatment process. I've included a box, which it won't always be needed, but for dosing and flow equalization. And then we have our secondary treatment unit. And this setup is typically good for 50 to 75% of total nitrogen removal. I've also included here this little kind of extra piece that we sometimes suggest that you do, which takes a portion of the treated water at the outlet here and recirculates it back to the inlet. And that does help some with total nitrogen reduction. When you need a higher percentage removal of total nitrogen, that's when this NitroFast and ABCN comes into play. So the treatment train down below here shows all those same steps as above, but now we're adding a NitroFast step to perform complete or additional nitrification, and then that nitrified wastewater stream goes through the ABCN for denitrification and what is considered a post-anoxic process for anyone that might need to explain that to an engineer. So notice the recirculation step is still there, and it's always after your very last recirculation or your very last aerobic system. You wouldn't necessarily recirculate after the ABCN, we just put it right after the NitroFast. These indicate chemical feed sources. So sometimes to maximize the amount of nitrogen that you can remove, you have to keep the chemistry of the wastewater in balance. The two chemicals that supply that balance are alkalinity, and alkalinity is supplied primarily by a chemical like baking soda, sometimes by a stronger base such as sodium hydroxide, but we typically recommend that you use baking soda. It's a lot safer to handle. And then on the denitrification process, one of the limiting factors in that process is often a carbon source, and a carbon source, what it really is BOD. And so a lot of times the balance of BOD and total nitrogen is not quite where it needs to be, so you have to add more BOD in the form of a carbon source, And there's chemicals like the chemical brand Micro-C, which adds that organic carbon source back into the wastewater so that the denitrifying bacteria can eat that up. So a lot of times we'll tell you if you need to target a really low total nitrogen limit, that you should plan to include chemical feed lines at least, if not a complete system for adding those chemicals.